Tierra. Earth. We live on a rocky planet. And geology is the science that studies the solid earth, the rocks that make it up, and how those rocks form and change over time.
Hey everyone, it's Danny with the Chucky Meadows Parks Foundation, and today we got an adventure for you. We're gonna go on a little tour of the geology found within the Reno area, and our adventure starts right here at the Huffaker Hills Trailhead with South Reno and the beautiful Carson Range in view. We're gonna be on the hunt for some rocks. We're looking for metamorphic rocks, volcanic rocks, granitic rocks, all the rocks in all this land. So let's go. First stop, we find ourselves just down Huffaker Trail at a nice pile of rocks here. Just down the trail, and we already see this vast volcanic rock field. Most of the rocks in this area were formed from volcanoes and hot lava and magmas. These rocks, as they cooled, release volatile gases that creates this pitting structure on the rock. So pick up the rocks, feel the rocks, and you can feel the rough texture formed from when these rocks cooled. So we're gonna continue on down the trail and see what other cool volcanic rocks we can find.
Upon closer inspection of these volcanic rocks, we find lichen growing on them. Lichens are actually two types of organisms, algae and fungi, that live together as one, creating a microenvironment on rocks and other materials such as wood. Many lichens contain acids that break down or erode rock into smaller pieces, in addition to eroding rocks with its fungal threads. Moving on along through these volcanic fields, we're making our way to the other side of Huffaker Hills.
Here we are, just on the other side of the Huffaker Hills, at Huffaker Lookout. We were coming for the geology, but we're staying for the views and shrubs. So here we are, we've made our way up the trail. We're enjoying the nice desert shrubs and the beautiful views, but we're on the hunt for a very special rock. We got our volcanic rocks here, but this is this very special volcanic rock called obsidian. It's a type of volcanic glass. So we're gonna keep searching around these volcanic rocks and see if we can find our special obsidian. Alright, we made it to the top of this hill. We can enjoy the great views of Reno and the surrounding mountains, but we're not done here yet. We still gotta find this obsidian. So, we're gonna keep exploring.
Wait, what's that? Whoa.
No way! Look what we just found. Obsidian. Like we said before, this is a type of volcanic glass. And when chunks break off from the main piece, they can have very sharp edges. And indigenous people have used obsidian for centuries to make cutting tools and piercing tools.
Obsidian is formed when felsic lava flows from a volcano and cools very quickly. And when it cools quickly, there's minimal crystal growth.
This is a very lucky find we have here. If we find this chunk here, we know there's got to be a larger deposit somewhere in the Huffaker area. Really cool. Would you have a look at that? Remember, when you're out here in these open areas checking out the rocks, it's best to follow your leave no trace principles. Given that this has been used by indigenous peoples in the past, this very well could be an artifact. And we don't want to remove an artifact from its environment. So when we're done studying this, it's best that we just leave it where we found it. So I'm just going to place it back on the ground here. And remember this memory for always.
Next on our geologic tour of Reno, we're steaming along Steamboat Creek.
Here we are just south of Reno at the Steamboat Hot Springs, which is once a field of volcanic lava domes and flows. Now, this is evidence of the active geology and volcanic activity in northern Nevada. Here you can still find hot springs, steam vents, and fumaroles, which is actually a crack, the opening in the Earth's crust, which emits steam and gases from below, which are heated up by the volcanic activity below the ground here.
Here we have an active steam vent that has been modified with this metal pipe. Probably people were soaking in the hot spring here. But here, this pipe leading down leads straight down to active geology. There's hot magma down there. It's heating up all the water. It's sending up the steam and this gas. There used to be these all over this area. Check it out. Can they come in? Check this out. You gotta be careful in this area because this steam is very hot. And there's lots of volcanic gases coming up through here.
One last thought before we move on to our next location. Indigenous peoples have long held these natural volcanic hot springs as a sacred place. So please be respectful when you visit the hot springs.
Alright, now we came down to the Truckee River to study up the rocks down here. And these rocks are very interesting to study because this is not where the rocks were formed. They were actually formed deep underground. And when our Sierra Nevada mountains were created, these rocks were forced upward and eventually they eroded in the Lake Tahoe area, and the flow of the river has brought them to where they are today. And also, this flow over time has rounded the rocks year after year, century after century. Water has flowed over these rocks, smoothed them out, and made them round. And that's what we see today in the Truckee River.
Granite forms when specific kinds of hot magma slowly solidify underground. Granite is very hard and tough, which has made it become a common material in construction throughout human history. Do you see all the black, gray, and pink minerals that are visible to the unaided eye? Granite can be found throughout the Sierra Nevada range, and perhaps the most famous example are the steep granite cliffs that form the walls of Yosemite Valley. Thank you for following along on this fantastic geologic voyage. Hopefully you can get out and explore some rockin' geologic spots yourself. With that, we're gonna move on to the experiment, and we're gonna join up with naturalist Keaton. Take it away, Keaton.
Volcanoes are a really interesting and dynamic way that new rock is formed. We don't have a lot of that happening here right now, so for our experiment today, we'll be making our own model volcanoes.
For your volcano, you'll need water, vinegar, baking soda, a clean, empty plastic bottle, a cup to mix things in, and optional is the dish soap and red food coloring. You might find it helpful to construct a funnel out of paper if you don't have one at home. Mix together 4 parts vinegar with 1 part water.
I used 1 cup of vinegar and 1/4 cup of water.
Add a squeeze of dish soap and a few drops of food coloring. None of these measurements have to be exact. You might want to add more food coloring than I did because my lava didn't turn out to be very red. Give it a gentle shake to mix it all up, and we're ready to construct our volcano. Set your bottle upright. I used a plastic tub for easy cleanup. And then using Play-Doh, rocks, or dirt, really whatever you have on hand, you can go ahead and put your volcano together. Once you get to the top of the volcano, don't forget to take the cap off of your bottle. Volcanoes come in all different shapes and sizes, so everyone is gonna look a little bit different. Here's my finished product. And we're gonna set that aside. And once again, the measurements are not exact, but mix about 1 part baking soda with 2 parts water. It may not all dissolve in the water, and that's okay. Just make sure you stir it as well as you can, and then pour it in your volcano to watch the eruption. That happens pretty quick, so let's watch it again in slow motion. After the initial eruption, the foam moves down the side of our model volcano the same way a lava flow would on a real volcano.
The volcanic rocks we found earlier are evidence there were once active volcanoes in northern Nevada.
We can use our models to learn about real volcanoes. We can ask questions like, how does the shape of the volcano affect the eruption? Does it change the way the bubbles flow down the sides like lava? You can also experiment with different amounts of baking soda and vinegar, the 2 main ingredients in our volcanoes. Just remember, when you finish with your experiment, clean up after yourself and leave the space better than you found it.
All right, that's it from us from the Truckee Meadows Park Foundation. We hope you enjoyed the video and stay tuned next month for your next newsletter adventure.